Today we are discussing about the balance, the last episode for basic terms of accounting, which are so important. Those terms only we are discussing, which are not so important, we are not discussing about them. While solving the problems itself, we can discuss about them, right? So today we are discussing about assets. We are discussing about assets. What are assets? Assets, already we have discussed what is the meaning of asset. Those are future benefits for us, right? So those are called as future receivables, future benefits. Altogether we call that as assets. Now here, assets are divided into three. Assets are classified into three types of assets, we can call them. One is fixed asset, current asset and fictitious assets. Now what are fixed assets? What are fixed assets? Easy term, if I tell, which cannot be converted into cash immediately. Which cannot be converted into cash immediately. I will take an example. Okay, I am having land. I purchased one land which has 2400 square feet. Which is total 2400 square feet. I am expecting the price of 65 lakhs. So do you think, if I keep for sale by tomorrow, am I able to sell off this item? Do you think I can sell? It's not at all possible. It is not at all possible. It will take very long time since the amount is very huge. Okay. I want to sell my mobile, which costed 25,000. Put in the OLX. Immediately it starts. I want to purchase. Are you willing to sell? Within a week I can sell off. Do you think 65 lakhs property I am able to sell immediately? Do you think I can sell that one? No, it is not possible. It is not at all possible. So such kind of assets are called as fixed assets, which cannot be converted into cash immediately. Those are called as fixed assets. Or else you can enjoy those benefits more than a year. It will be with you more than a year. Those are also called as fixed assets. Okay. Current assets. Do you think current assets will stay with us more than years or not? It's not possible. If I take the example, cash, if I take, cash will stay longer time with us. No, it will be keep on flowing. You will receive, you will send back, you will pay, and again you will be receiving. Such kind of things, transactions can happen. So cash cannot be treated as fixed assets. It will be treated as current asset only. Bank balance, if you see, bank balance, if you have FD, fixed deposits, for 3 years, 4 years, again it will be moving to the fixed assets only, not to the current assets. Got it? Stock, if you take, that also, it's keep on flowing. It will not stay with you. You will be selling that immediately. So that is also treated as current asset. If you take debtors means it is the biggest thing. Okay, you can tell, ma'am, I will give credit to someone for 10 years, 20 years. Nobody will give like that. Okay, they will, if they want to give also, again they will rewrite their document between them. Okay, but they will not keep that for very longer time. So these all are treated as current assets, which can be converted into cash immediately. Those are called as current assets. Got it? Now fixed assets, give me some examples. Buildings, will you stay? If you purchase the building, will you stay here only for 1 year, 1 month, 2 months? Nothing like that, right? When we are purchasing, our way of thinking will be, we are gonna keep that asset for longer time, more than a year, more than 10 years, 20 years, some of them, their lifetime they want to spend over there only. Machinery, such kind of things also can come over there. Again, fixed assets were segregated into two types. Those are tangible assets and intangible assets. Those are tangible assets and intangible assets. What are tangible assets? Tangible assets in the sense which you can see, feel and touch. You can see the building, you can see the land, isn't it? So all those things will come under tangible asset, which you can see and feel. Then intangible assets, which you cannot see them or feel them. Example, we want to know how it will be explained as intangible asset. Okay, then I'll give you an example. All of you would have ate chicken, right? There are so many chicken lovers will be there. K KFC chicken, everyone knows, right? Many of them, they use, there might be mouth watering here, I know that. So KFC is there. KFC is there in my area, in your area, Munna's area. We are doing business of Munna's, okay? In Munna's area, there is KFC and there is BFC. There is KFC and there is BFC. Both the price is same. Both the price is same. And distance from his house is same. Now tell me where he will go. Will he go to KFC or will he go to BFC? When price is same, why do I go for imitation? I don't want to go for imitation, right? If the price is same, I would like to buy KFC only. That is called name. That is called name. So, goodwill. Goodwill kind of words will come as intangible assets. Or as patents, you invented something. So, those patent rights you can take. Copyrights you can take. Okay, copyrights. Take the movie field. Take the movie field only. There itself you can take the best examples for copyrights. Recent movies, Arjun Reddy. It has remaked into Hindi. Correct? When they are remaking that, can they remake directly? No, first they have to pay copyrights to the producer and then only they can pay those copyrights also intangible asset. Got it? So these are tangible assets, intangible assets, fixed assets, current assets. All are over. Now, fictitious assets. What are these fictitious assets? Okay. I am having very good business. Okay, I wanted to do more and more marketing. For marketing, I have done some advertising. Okay, advertising is not a small thing for me. I have spent around 50,000. I have spent around 50,000 for advertisement. How much I spent? 50,000 I spent for advertising my product. And I'm expecting up to 5 years it will take. It will stay with me. Okay, up to 5 years I may get the benefit of this advertisement. So, will I show now itself this 50,000? No. What I will do, when I am showing the expenses, I will show for the first year 10,000 as expense, other 40,000 as asset. Got it? When I am showing for the second year, another 10,000 I will show here as expense. And here 30,000 I will be showing as asset. Got it? So this fictitious asset does not have any value. You can't see them. You can't feel them. This is not tangible. This is not intangible. It has zero value. Already you have spent. But the benefit you are gonna enjoy till 5 years, so till 4 years, whatever is there, or till 3 years, till 2 years next, whatever is there, balance will be treated as asset. Then for the third year, again I am writing 10,000 as expense and again 20,000 I will show it as asset. Understood what are fictitious assets? Now we discussed fixed assets in the tangible and intangible, again current assets and then fictitious assets. These are types of assets. Now let us know what are the types of liabilities. It will not take much time. Okay, we'll learn what are the types of liabilities. Now we are learning about liabilities. Liabilities are the obligations or responsibilities of the business. Okay, so in the future you are going to make the payment. You are going to take the responsibility of that item. Okay, those are liabilities. In that we are having two types of liabilities. Those are non-current liabilities and current liabilities. Non-current liabilities also called as long-term liabilities. They are also called as long-term liabilities. Current liabilities are short-term liabilities. Okay, where I mentioned long-term and short-term, you would have understood the meaning, right? So, these non-current liabilities which has time between above 1 year to 10 years, something like that. Got it? Those are non-current liabilities. You are having time till that time, more than 1 year. It can be the loan. Sometimes you may take a house loan or something. It will go on 10 years, 20 years, something like that. No? Those all are will be coming under that. Okay. And come to the current liabilities. Current liabilities in the sense, within 1 year, within 1 year, you have to clear. Within 1 year, you have to clear. It can be treated as bank overdraft. You have utilized more money than what you have. You are having only 10,000 in your account, but you have utilized 11,000. So that 1,000 will be treated as overdraft that you will be paying within months along with interest. Okay, and more than that, what we can call creditors also in the same way it will come. You will be paying the credit within time, within 1 year. Okay, those kind of within 1 year which can be cleared, those are called as current liabilities, which is having the time more than 1 year, up to 10 years also you can take the time. Those all are called as non-current or long-term liabilities. All of you understood these current liabilities and long-term current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Now I'm gonna give you the notes. You can write down the notes along with the class itself. Later you will not find any difficulty. Is it all of you understood? Okay, fine. If you're having any doubts, please mention in the comments. If you like the video, please don't wait. Share this to many students. Let any one student get the benefit because of this video. We will be very happy. Okay. Thank you. Like, share and subscribe. Bye-bye.